Morning. This is Arnie Waters here at Waters Capital. As indicated to you, gold was likely to stay around $1,500 an ounce. We're looking for quiet trade this week, absent any big international developments. And we expect gold to trade between $1,499 and $1,510 over the weekend. We expect gold then to resume its upward march. We encourage you to ignore the Communist Party in South Africa's calls for nationalist mining, for nationalizing mining, because it is not government policy and is not likely to ever get to be government policy. It is simply an effort by some factions of the ANC to cause trouble. We also want to point out to you that during this difficult time, we need to be aware that the Chinese economy is no day at the beach. Many observers feel strongly that the Chinese are, in many ways, almost as bad off as Greece. It's only the size of their population and the size of their commercial base that is presently saving them. They made tremendously ridiculous loans. Go look up ghost cities if you don't believe me, and check out the amount of money that the Chinese have completely wasted. And they have a whole lot of properties that are half-built, way underwater, all the usual stuff. And that overhang is going to be very costly to the Chinese economy in the next little while. Now, it may not be a problem in the next 90 days, but certainly over the next 24 months. And trade is going to be affected. When I say trade, I mean stock market type trade is going to be affected by that. We expect the uranium market to remain strong. We remind you, that the contract price of uranium has gone all the way from $74 to $73, okay? So we expect the contract price of uranium going forward to remain high, even though there may be some disruptions of pricing in the intraday or spot market. So aim for the ice flows, not the open water. Have a great day. Keep swinging.